first things first. I had gotten, 25 pounds of peaches from Bountiful Baskets, where I gave Alicia a bunch, and I think she probably already bragged about that, because they're super yummy. So they're mostly small. We call them freestone peaches. I'm not sure what actually they call them here in Arizona. But what happens when you cut these open, the pit comes right out of them, so hence freestone. But I'm not quite sure if that's actually the correct name for these. They're from Utah. And I'll show you the little process that we're going to do to do these. And super simple. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is I have a bunch of peaches, 24 pounds of peaches. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a few things. First of all, what you want to do is you need to take the skin off the peaches and the pits out of the peaches. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to blanch them. And you could really do that with a lot of different vegetables. You could do it with tomatoes, if anything that you want to get the skin off of. And what blanching means is you plunge it in boiling water for maybe 30 seconds, take it out, put it in ice cold water, okay, and then the peel will come right off of it. So what happens is when you put it in the boiling water, it releases the skin or the peel or whatever your outer coating of whatever vegetable or fruit that you have. And then when you put it in the cold ice water bath, it stops the cooking process. It kind of shocks it, and really, the skin just peels right off. It's a great way if you're doing sauce or anything like that. People have been doing it this way for years. It's a heck of a lot easier than taking a knife and peeling the whole thing, honestly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to blanch these peaches, and I'll show you how I do that. And I'm going to make a simple syrup. And what that is, you could do it different ways. So say that you have a can of peaches in heavy syrup, or you have a can of peaches in light syrup. All that is the how much sugar they're putting in the water. So I prefer a light syrup, or you could use fruit juice and look online and find a recipe how to do that. And my light syrup is 2 cups of sugar to 6 cups of water, which seems sweet, but it's gonna go over. I'm gonna use these freezer boxes, and so it's gonna go over probably 4 or 5 of them. So it's really not that terribly much, and they just need it. And then I'm gonna also use this Fruit Fresh, which makes your fruit not brown, and it's an ascorbic acid, so it makes it not turn or get a little funky on you in the freezer. So.
Okay, so we have our boiling water and our peaches. So what I'm gonna do is, and I'm just gonna show you one quickly. So I'm gonna take the peach, I'm gonna put it in the boiling water, okay? There it is there, and I'm just gonna put it for 45 seconds, which that should be 45 seconds, okay? Little strainer like that. Okay, so you wanna put the peaches in an ice water bath. When you take it out of the ice water, you could really just peel the peel right off, and that's what you're looking for. So that's similar, so that's really why you're blanching something. So it makes it so much easier that you're going to cut it, slice it, and be good to go. Okay, so I made a simple syrup, and it's 2 cups of sugar, 6 cups of water. What you do is you bring it to a boil, and I did that, and then I let it cool. I sliced up all my peaches. I put a little bit of this Fruit Fresh, which is basically ascorbic acid, and it just keeps it from browning, okay? And you could really use that on any kind of fruit that you're gonna cut up. You know, even fruit salad, you could throw it in there. There's really not a whole lot of taste to it, but it just prevents the browning, okay? So I sliced up all my peaches, and I put them in freezer boxes. I bought freezer boxes at the grocery store, Glad freezerware freezer boxes. You know what, you could do it in Ziploc bags, you could do it, you know, in any other kind of Ziploc containers that you want. But these seem to work good because they kind of keep the freezer burn at bay. So I sliced them up. Some of them I sliced kind of not perfect, but some of them, you know, are really, really good slices. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the simple syrup. I'm waiting for it to cool. I'm going to pour the simple syrup on top, and then I'll show you the next piece. Now we're just going to add a little bit of the simple syrup to the peaches. It's really, as I said before, you can make the syrup any way that you want to. And they're, you know what, these are, they're not cut perfectly, but they are just fine. They will be delicious. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little piece of Saran wrap. Actually, this is Glad wrap or whatever works. And put it on top, okay? And then I'm going to put the top on it. And what happens is the Saran wrap will just push the peaches underneath the liquid. And that's what you want so it doesn't get freezer burn. It's just a quick little trick that was from my mother-in-law taught me a long time ago. These are going to get stacked in the freezer. And then when you want them for dessert or whatever in the wintertime, you take them out like right when you're starting your dinner. And they're nice chilled ice chipped peaches for dessert, and they're just yummy. So, good luck, and we'll see you soon. See ya.